G'day, I'm Glenn Morris from the Smart Energy Lab, and I'm here on day two of All Energy. After 3 years of waiting, we're finally here. It's fantastic. And I'm here with Craig Hunter from PowerPlus-Energy. How are you doing, Craig?
Yeah, I'm going really well.
Is this the right hand to shake?
Yeah, that's the right hand to shake. So, you know, well, they're both stuffed, but you know, so here we go.
So have you broken anything lately?
No, I haven't, but my son has. So, you know, he's following in my footsteps. So
nice.
He just snapped his collarbone off his shoulder.
Motorbike?
No, that was a mountain bike, so
oh, okay.
Yeah.
As long as it wasn't falling over in the shower.
Yeah, that's it.
Great. Well, we're standing in front of probably the bigger tower of power that you've got here.
Yep.
And it's got some red stuff. What's going on up there?
So this is our new Escape 20 series inverter, well, all-in-one BESS solutions. What we've got here is a modular inverter, bi-directional inverter system, and it's here at the moment we've got 12 modules in here, and it's a total of 28.8 kilowatts. Of output power and 36 kilowatts of either generator or grid input power.
Wow, 28 kilowatts, three phase, I presume?
Correct, yeah, you can do three phase or single phase. This one's is a three phase system. They're a modular hot swappable solution. So simply you can just grab one of the modules when it's in operation, take it out if you need to service. All the rest of them will actually keep on operating. The rest of the inverters in the phase will pick up the slack. Once you get a new replacement, if that's what you need to do, you can simply slide the unit in. If I can get this one in, away we go. No need to reprogram it. The actual cluster will automatically reprogram that device and the system's ready to go.
So there's no kind of manager?
No manager, it's a cluster environment. So,
right,
yeah.
Wow, that's amazing. So this is kind of like, you know, hard drives with RAID arrays. You can just plug them out and they just recover.
Yeah, the idea of this whole system was to have some sort of low mean time to repair or an M+1 sort of redundancy. So as you can see with the whole solution, you know, we've got our self-managed batteries in here. It's actually our new battery, the Life4838P. It's 15% more energy dense. Hot swappable, easy to go. Simply turn your breakers off and undo them, similar to the rest of them. We've actually incorporated as well the AERL rack mount MPPTs as well.
Hey, I didn't even notice that. Wow, so this has got AC charging capability.
Correct.
Was it 38 kilowatts?
It's 28.8, so it's 36 kilowatts of charging.
36 kilowatts of charging, and inverter power is?
28.8 kilowatts.
28.8, and then you've got, what, 30 kilowatts of?
24 kilowatts 24. Of AERL MPPTs that can be overrun by, 50%, as normal sort of things, so up to 36 kilowatts of PV can be connected.
This is an awesome piece of kit. And how much storage have we got in here?
You've got 129 kilowatt hours of storage in total.
Wow, so who do you think would want one of these?
Look, probably a lot of you.
Apart from me.
Now, part of you, you can have one if you like. You know, surely we can put one up at your place. So lots of people are thinking of these. High-end sort of larger off-grid solutions are definitely going to want these. We have a baby brother to this as well with 64 kilowatt hours. And we have a product called Escaflex where you can actually put as many batteries as you like and select from your inverters as well. So you can actually scale this system down if you like for smaller off-grid systems. But this system can scale to about 1.8 megawatts when you start putting multiples of these cabinets together, up to 48 of them. So mine sites, microgrids, wherever it needs to go. So it's almost an endless opportunity in size that we can do.
I can see the key word here is flexibility. So you can choose how many of these you got, whether a single, split phase, three phase, how much storage you want.
Yep.
You can parallel more storage. You basically say to the customer, what do you want? How much generation, how much power, how much storage, we can build it.
Yeah, 100%. So we have some standard models. There's about six standard models that we try and, I guess, pigeonhole people so that they can know exactly what the capabilities are of the product. They can either select from that or they can come and talk to the team and we can customize a full solution. So you may find that you may have a very, very large generator and you actually want to charge the batteries a lot faster. So we actually have some rack mount rectifiers or chargers, as the industry knows here, that we can put in here as well to complement the charging power into it. So we can customize what we need to do. More DC MPPTs if you want, or you may choose to AC couple the system with either a Fronius or an SMA inverter as well.
So those who aren't familiar with AERL, these units here, these are new, the new rack mount ones.
Yep.
What's their maximum input voltage?
Maximum input voltage is 600 volts. So you can go with your standard sort of grid connect high string voltages. So it makes it very, very easy installation.
Yeah. And as for monitoring, have you got a monitoring solution?
Yeah, we've partnered, we've switched in on the monitoring platform. So they're doing a custom platform for us at the moment. The first round and first release of it is monitoring only. Throughout the year, throughout 2023, we'll be releasing alerts and emails and those sorts of things that you can do. And then after there, we'll actually do performance monitoring as well, where the system can actually tell you if there's a potential issue and those sorts of things, to give you pre-warnings to come and do some maintenance.
Now, I presume looking at the cabinet, this is outdoor rated.
Yeah, this is a dual skin, fully insulated, outdoor rated cabinet. Standard units have fan force cooling. However, there's options for air conditioners and heat exchangers and all those sorts of things that you can add onto it. So it can be installed in full sun, basically.
So in terms of environmental controls, it's got double skinning. Do you have any other requirements for ventilation and cooling?
So we've got the full insulation on the inside here, and then we have we've got the air conditioning, all the fans that we can put on there as well. So.
Right, so full thermal management.
Full thermal management, yes.
This is a drop it and run kind of solution.
Yeah, so you can sort of, I don't know if you can see, the camera can see from the bottom, but basically it's forklift lift up or crane. You basically do a concrete pad with your cables coming up. It's got easy entries on the bottom, and you just basically go up and over your cables and terminate off, and away you go.
I could see this being paired with EV charging solutions where the network capacity's undersized.
Yeah, most definitely. And the good thing about this is it's got a true sort of online UPS functionality. So if it's used in a grid or an off-grid application, the actual grid or generator is totally isolated from the load output with a no break transfer.
Right, yeah. So no problems with, you know, frequency shift on your generator.
Yeah, that's right. And it does total load balancing on the grid and the generator as well. So no matter what's going on, the phase outputs of this, the load, the grid or the generator will have totally balanced phases.
Yeah, wow. Cool. Well, thanks, Craig. Super exciting. You just get bigger and better every time.
Yeah, look, we've been listening to the market. The market's been telling us they've been wanting this. So we've finally done it.
Cool one.
Thanks very much.
Thanks so much,
Glenn.
See ya.
Enjoy the rest of the show.
I will.